Alright, what is going on guys? It's Tazz here, and welcome back to the channel. Now today what I want to talk to you guys about is one of my favorite shows from the summer that has just aired its finale recently, that being Cloak and Dagger. Now before I get into anything, there will not be any major spoilers for the season, so don't worry about that, I will just be talking about a few small details to help get my point across. But without any further ado guys, let's get into the video. Cloak and Dagger was a short 10 episode run summer show that aired on the Freeform network, and it followed Tyrone Johnson and Tanny Bowen on their journey to discovering their powers and connection, as well as progressing towards the comic book characters of Cloak and Dagger respectively. And I'll be completely honest here, before watching this show I had very little comic knowledge of these two characters. I only knew a couple of little facts here and there from a few videos as well as from the Ultimate Spider-Man animated series. But beyond that, I went into the series with very little knowledge of these characters, and I was pleasantly surprised. And I guess you could say that the show does start off a bit slow. It doesn't really get going until like the end of the second episode, but once it does, it is pretty great. And while you can pretty much say that about any show that it starts off kind of slow, this one is totally worth the slow build up for everything. Cloak and Dagger is not a super action heavy show, but what it is a show that's focused a lot on character development and world building rather than on a bunch of action and jokes. While that element is still present throughout, it is not the main focus. The best way to compare it would be to a Marvel Netflix show or even The Runaways, as opposed to something like a CW show. And that is not a bad thing at all for this show to be different in that way. All of the development makes the payoff in an action scene just that much greater. And I think that small character moments are the real standouts of Cloak and Dagger. And like I said earlier, if you're looking for sort of an idea of what you're getting yourself into with Cloak and Dagger, if you've seen Marvel's Runaways, then that is basically what Cloak and Dagger is going to be. They are very similar as far as budget and season layout and even tone goes, so I think that Marvel's Runaways is really your best bet as to a sort of comparison that you can give for Cloak and Dagger. And I think that it is pretty funny that they did air Runaways on Hulu, and then Cloak and Dagger is also available on Hulu, and then after the Cloak and Dagger finale, they actually did air the first episode of Runaways on Freeform. So that's a little kind of like a coincidence, I guess. I don't know, maybe they're saying that they want to do a crossover at some point. I would be totally down for that. Like I said, these shows are very similar in tone and everything, and I think they would definitely mesh very well together. So, you know, fingers crossed that maybe we get a Cloak and Dagger Runaways crossover at some point in the future. But back on topic with Cloak and Dagger, I also did really like all of the music throughout the season. Great music is always a plus in my book. And one thing that some people may not like, but I found it pretty interesting and a pretty cool part of the show, and that was how they were not afraid to tackle some big social issues within the context of the show. They weren't hitting you over the head with politics or anything, but in my opinion, they did a pretty good job of presenting the world of Cloak and Dagger in a similar way to the world that we all live in. But throughout the season, we follow Ty and Tandy on their journey from the night that they got their powers to their first meeting to learning how to use their powers on their own and together, all culminating in the finale, Cloak and Dagger coming together as the quote-unquote divine pairing to take on the threats to their city. All of the progression and development this season was pretty awesome. Seeing where the characters started and where they ended up in only 10 episodes, I think that the 10 episode order for the season worked perfectly, especially for a summer series. It was great to have a show to come back to every week during the summer as sort of a holdover for when everything comes back in the fall. So overall guys, I really did enjoy season 1 of Cloak and Dagger and highly suggest you guys go check it out if you're looking for something to hold you over until everything else comes back in the fall. I think you can watch this season on Hulu or the Freeform app, so definitely go and watch it if you haven't already. And if you guys have seen season 1 of Cloak and Dagger in its entirety, tell me what you thought about it down in the comments below. In my opinion, Cloak and Dagger has been a pretty underrated show, and it was actually really enjoyable. I also did really enjoy the finale as well, and I think it sets up quite nicely for season 2. So I want to know your thoughts on all of this down in the comments below. But until next time guys, it's been Tazz, and I will see you guys in the next video.